Hey there. So you've been watching my Twitter feed, which is basically posts of all of my blood sugar readings. And I figure today I should show you how I actually get those numbers. Now, I've been scouring the internet looking for exactly when home monitoring became available, because originally you'd have to go to the doctor and get either your blood work done or urine samples taken, and that's how you would kind of know if you were on target. Other than that, you were up to your own devices to just listen to your body and look for symptoms and look for signals and adjust accordingly. So now, thanks to a lovely electronic device, we have home blood glucose meters. And so this thing right here comes with me everywhere. Everywhere I go. And yes, to answer the question, I have lost this numerous times, and sometimes I find it, and sometimes it disappears forever. So actually, this one is number three. So here is, oh, actually, I should note that I have a smaller one that I keep at home for those times when I do lose it. So that's my backup. But this is my blood glucose meter, and there's a meter there. And then this is the thing that actually pricks my finger to draw blood. And then this is a canister holding a bunch of test strips. All right, so here's how this works. The canister actually has a number on it, and you need to make sure that you match this number to your meter, because if you don't, you can get all sorts of really funny readings that are not true. So, as you note, it says 25, and we'll make sure that my meter also says 25. Now, inside this guy are a bunch of test strips, and the test strips look like that. There we go. So basically, this side goes into the meter, and this side is where you put in the blood. All right, so let me grab that meter. Here we go. Fun. All right, so there's my meter, and here's the test strip. And it goes right in there. Now it turns on automatically. And as you can see, here we go. We've got 25. So both things are matching up. Now it transitions and asks for you to apply blood. So here's the fun part where you basically grab this guy and prick yourself. Now, what this is basically a small needle. See that guy right there? Okay. So you can adjust this thing to puncture. See, right now it's at 7. I think it's like 1 through 9. So you can make it go fast, like deeper or shallower. But right now it's at 7 and it moves like that fast. So, all right. So you can see there's all sorts of little tiny puncture wounds on my hands, but I'm gonna go ahead and use my pinky because I haven't used it in a while. And so I've punched a hole. Oop, I'm trying to do this for the camera and it's harder than you think. And basically, see, there's the blood. So I make it come out a little bit more. I hope you're not squeamish. It's kind of going along the lines of my thing, but I think that's enough. So from here, I grab my meter. Doing this backwards is hard. And there we go. Sorry, that was the most awkward thing. But as you can see, in a matter of seconds, I got my blood sugar reading, which is 92. It may be reversed for you. I'm gonna wipe off my finger. But my blood sugar reading right now is 92, which is good, actually, because I ate about two, a little more than 2 hours ago, so I'm not gonna give myself any insulin. But this number right here, whenever I grab it, basically is one of the tools I use to guess at how much insulin I need, and guess is the right term for that, because I use that number with how much food I've eaten, with have I exercised or will I be exercising, and is anything stressing me the heck out right now. All of these things combine to kind of tell myself the amounts of insulin I need. Now, before I leave you today, I just want to tell you one thing when talk about the cost of this thing, because this is actually something that costs quite a bit in the long term. I have health insurance, thankfully, so a lot of this is covered. And I will say, like, the meter is actually given to me by my doctor free, because it's not the meter that costs a bunch. It's actually these little guys, like these little test strips. Now, if you go to the pharmacy, meters are anywhere from like $19.99 and up, or you can get them from your doctor for free. But the strips themselves are actually, well, these ones right here, I use One Touch Ultra, and 25 of them is $34.99 without insurance. 100 of them is like $135. You can buy generic, and for 100 generic, it's about $65. So this brand is double. But I don't pay that much because of insurance, thank God. But 100 strips, if you're testing, you know, five times a day, only covers you for 20 days. That's a 20-day supply. And we all test in different numbers, but you test anywhere from 3 to 10 times a day. So it adds up. So I hope that's informative. So that's how I test my blood sugar. And I'm 92, so I'm good to go. And I will see you next time. All right. Cheers.